apparently every statue gets the procs, gets the damage output, and your heroes start to melt.
Gotta love Aghanim Scepter timings. And now, Fissure, well, your catch three. Ice Blast is coming in. There is no Echo Slam, however, and the Ice Blast actually doesn't hit anybody. They just play around it. Now Rolling Thunder. Quick little Yule Scepter up towards the air. That was his own Yule Scepter as well from BZZ, but Brax way too far forward. He doesn't have a teammate to work with, and Brax so low on life. One charge will buy him a little bit more time to clean up a wave, but you just lost Monkey, you just lost Rubick, and you just lost Mars, and you may have actually just lost a huge chunk of momentum in this game. Nine's trying to actually push a side lane to repair some of the damage.
It feels like I'm watching like an egg toss, you know? Both teams just sort of tossing the game back and forth.
This
and
is how we do the Humpty Dance.
Yeah, the yolk's going to get on somebody's face, and we may see a game three at this rate, but you know, I know it's 4-on-5, but again, it's like both teams sort of expecting, oh, if we get that enemy mid player, if he's dead, we're going to win this fight. But it's the spell usage, it's the supports that are still the threat. Monkey just gets straight up 100-0'd on the high ground. You can't allow those to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man, that is... Oof.
They're going to keep an eye on Roshan. One of those couriers should actually stay inside the pit. He will be up in 15 seconds. And in fact, that's exactly what happens.
Yep. And again, I point to the item build on 9. In theory, everything, even, you know what it is? It's the bots, Toby. I liked it. It was really early. Look at them. Also, look at this. Are they planning for the future? I mean, I understand that there's like a viral thing going on, but I don't know if you need that many mangoes in base. What do you think, Toby? They've got supplies for weeks to come. Yeah, yep. Camera left. Camera down left, down left, down left.
Yeah, just a little bit
look at that.
Hey, that guy.
All right. What?
What we're trying to do is we're making slushies with original fruit.
True. I will say, anybody, if you ever come to Kyiv, the homemade lemonade is sort of a thing here. Uh-huh. It is so good. So many places. One of my favorite things about Ukraine in general. And excellent spot if you're looking to be a digital nomad anywhere. Anyway, mid lane. BKB, Aegis up.
Coming from the expert nomad of all the Dota talent is Kyle.
I'm still, I'm homeless. I figured I might as well have the look to match. Thus, I've forsaken shaving until the age of 37.
Yes, well, that's not going to stick. That's like Slacks is like, I'm not going to shave until there's a patch.
Oh, man.
Never forget the broken promise, Slacks. Your word means nothing now. Brax no feels comment. A little far out if they can actually get the rupture. He's almost in range as well. And Brax, yep, too far up. But then again, they don't have information. Actually being saved by the nighttime.
It's just play business. Just fight in your base. You know, you need choke points now. You're not going to win an engagement unless you pick somebody off alone or the enemy team runs up into you. And I'm concerned about them looking to fight. Oh, wow, Ags on Mu. I mean, he is going for the statue build. It does make sense. And again, this is how you're going to have to win the fights defensive. Oh,
nice.
Hold up.
Blink, skewer back over on 19. Raise one, raise two, and now they might actually finish the
Pop
job.
BKB.
Ice Blast is coming in. The BKBs will protect it for the moment, but now you've also got the Rupture winding up that ultimate. He'll finally fly out, but who's going to be the first one to die? Bloodseek is being heavily focused down. Monkey can finally kill him off. BZZ, the walls have gone, but he's got the cheese up, and the extra life. Fanscore is the one to get the double kill out of this. It's still a 2-for-2 trade-off. They send the bear back up again. Nine wants to get rid of this damn thing, but over on the side, Rubick's having his own little battle with Vanskor as well as BZZ, but finally the battle will come to an end. A triple kill for Vanskor. He'll walk away with no life as the bear continues to get stun after root, after control on Thrax. He'll try and skewer BZZ up the hill, but it won't work as that bear, it needs to die, but the Ice Blast Brax needs to walk himself further away. He just gets far enough out. BZZ's looking for the swashbuckle attack to bring Mars low enough, but he has to use it to get away defensively. Gems are on the deck. BZZ's like, maybe I should be taking this one. Maybe I should not be dying as well. He'll move for the gem, but can he get out? Swashbuckle's up. He's up towards the hill, right in front of Nine. Nine hot on the tails. Has he got something? He's got Blink and Yule Scepter available, and that's exactly what he'll do. In fact, just the Blink was only required to get the raise. A double kill for him, and Fours will lose four. But the defense, it costs 3 buybacks. Man, CM, Monkey, as well as Mars.
It's just mistake after mistake, Toby. This game, a lot sloppier than the first. Bloodseeker, you have Aegis. And he pops the BKB and gets right clicked down. And then, you know, BA, they're like, hey, guys, let's just use everything on this one spot where he's going to come back up with no spell immunity. They do exactly that. Fight somewhat salvaged by the Lone Druid Bear. But ultimately, once it dies, there's nothing you can do but flee. And unfortunately, BZZ and Vanskor are the casualties. Yeah, you can see he pops it right there. What, he's 300 health. He just gets right clicked. And then it's, you see Mars Arena goes down, the SF ult with the BKB, the Wukongs. All of a sudden, the key heroes, the two cores, are just stuck.
You respawn back into a nightmare.
What is the chicken do? What is that? He's got, what is that? And Hertz, I understand that. I've made mistakes of that caliber, and I gotta tell you, it doesn't feel good. And Forz, you still have a lead. 10k gold very much in this game, but you gotta clean it up.
Well, they still have the number one net worth on the field. Nine is nipping on the heels after he's completed now the E-Blade, but the Monkey King bar is the new fresh item. Not to mention a Lotus Orb for the Ancient Apparition.
You just gotta relax a bit. I think Forza, they just keep your composure. Think about what it is you gotta do to win this game. And notably, it's to separate the arena from the Wukongs. Have one of those fights like you did around 20 minutes up by the up outpost. Mm-hmm. Split the fight.
Are we able to also confirm how we say their name? Is it Forza?
I'm just gonna keep changing it. I think you do it a different way.
Because it could be Forz, it could be Forza. Their official Twitter,
Forz-y.
Please tweet us and let us know.
Forzy.
We'd like to get it right.
Forze.
Make it sound French. Yeah. Everything sounds better in French.
I can definitely confirm that. Toby?
I'm good. Yeah, I'm good.
You're supposed to do the play-by-play, man. What's
yeah,
going?
Well, they're preparing, all right? And welcome to your new item, the Leveler. The leveler has arrived. The tier 4 Leveler. Now on to the Spirit Bear.
Jeez.
This is going like bonus building damage plus 25%.
And remember, there's not many buybacks remaining on this Radiant side.
Uh-huh.
You kill one or two cores, you just straight up go for throw and it dies in 20 seconds.
Don't kill the Wabbit, kill the bear. That's the plan. And Hex already over on Mars. A quick jump forward. Ice Blast coming in too. Braxton, a hell of a lot of trouble. I don't know if he'll really be able to survive this one. No, he will not. Dead for 2 minutes. Chu gets the stun control out, but Mu gets his BKB off. A waste of an Echo Slam. Now Mu. Well, maybe they do actually burn through him. Two heroes down without buyback available for such a long, long time. And a three-man fissure. They keep the stun control going, but what?
Jesus.
My God. Buildings are meant to stand the test of time, but we're really proving Ozymandias correct at the moment. That is a lost bottom lane of Rax. Another Yule Scepter set up over towards the Hexed Up Moose Rubik. A quick little force off tries to get him away, but Chu, he will bathe in the bath of mangoes.
That's last bear though, you gotta be cautious. That's the true hero of this dire side. It's gonna TP out and be able to be summoned back, and that's huge. And they've discovered the stash of mangoes. They ping it out.
Have I got an item slots? Razors, one, two, third one can't connect. So Pangolier surviving on 168 HP. Even the Fae Bolt unable to connect. But they're gonna take care of the objective-based gaming. Get rid of all the racks. It doesn't take you long with that bear. And there she blows. BA, this really should be over right now. It will take an absolute hallelujah play from 9 to save this game with amazing control from Moose and Fear, but it does seem very, very, very unlikely.
The repair kit, though.
That's great, but it's still not good enough. See that bear?
Another one.
See that bear? It does not care about repair kit. Now the jump in, but they got the Abyssal Blade stun off, so the BKB protected 9 is not really that protected. He can find back into this game. They get an extra Ice Blast to fly for him. He's already blinked himself further out, so he doesn't get connected by it, but Chu can't connect on the first stun. The Hex is out. Fear's keeping the control, but he lets it go, but no one's in range to actually feel the go. And maybe 9, yeah, he's down for the count. Mars is back to World of the Living. He'll get a great ultimate. Vanskor is low on life, but they all just stand in the middle. We'll play the arena. We'll play Gladiator. You can't rig this. And that is really GG. This game is over. It is done. It is dusted. And we will definitely get ourselves a decider for this first series of the mainstream of the minor.
Yeah, I mean, that's a game. The drafting, we had some questions, but on the back of a couple decisive teamfight wins, and of course that Lone Druid's absolutely insane damage out. But it feels like that game turned at the tier one bottom, right? And then that fighter on the outpost top just wasn't going business associates way. And once you're ahead with a lineup like Forza's in this game, you've got the superior initiation. You've got Chu with that like 22-minute blink Shadow Blade. And Alone Druid just shredding through structures. It's just easier to play the game. They got the Roshans this time, and a really nice victory there for the boys in red.
Might see that Lone Druid slip into the first phase bans and maybe mix up our draft a little bit more. They did decide to bypass it in game one. It was banned out in the second phase in game one. But maybe business associates need to just review their numbers and come back with a better proposal.
Yeah. I mean, I've talked with Blitz about this a lot. Like Liquid, it's they don't even care if people know. It's like, hey, you want to give us Lone Druid? We'll pick Lone Druid. We'll beat you with Lone Druid. This hero can do things that are not replicable, and that's why I love it so much. It's an incredibly strong laner, but notably, there's different ways to itemize, and you kill buildings better than any other hero in the game.
Especially when you get yourself a leveler.
It does help. Like, it does help.
What a nice change for tier fours. That's a terrific game. Either way, we get to come back for a final decider, so grab yourself a beverage, tick yourself in. Today might be a very long day, and we can't wait for game three.